I just replaced my clothing brand photographer in under 5 minutes using nothing more than a single product photo. No studio, no models, no cameras, no editing software, just one tool called Higgs Field. And the results were absolutely insane, which brought us to this video right here. And really quickly, if you don't know Higgs Field is part of a new wave of AI platforms that not only allow you to create professional level clothing brand photography, but now you could also technically create full blown commercials, video with audio, like all without ever booking models, setting up studios, or even picking up a camera yourself. And we've tested this and it's absolutely mind blowing. Now, in this video, what I really wanna break down is product photography. So let's say you have a t-shirt business with designs on just, you know, plain t-shirts, and you want to have models as part of your website photography. We always say, you know, the gold standard of product photography is going to be really the shirt on a white background, no other distractions, but having the shirt on a model does something for certain people, especially also like women tend to prefer to see the product on model more so than men. So the question was, can we essentially replace, you know, our current photography that has just plain white background and put those into actual models, and then maybe even put them on actual models that potentially look slightly different from, you know, one picture to the other, so that we get some variety throughout the website. And you probably use, you know, things like Placeit, you know, in order to get your design on a real person wearing a real shirt. I would say problems with things like Placeit is that you may end up looking like everyone else, right? Everyone else may be actually using some of the same models. And a lot of times it's gonna be hard to get that consistency and the differentiation, right? But like, it has to be different, but at the same time, it has to be the same. So we'll show you some examples, but really all the other thought experiment with, can we just use Higgs Field in order to create this? And I think we've been somewhat successful with this task. So the very first thing that we did, or we're going to do, is we're gonna go to Higgs Field, and when we click on create an image, in order for us to create the actual model photo that we'll be using. So we have the prompt right here, and for this exercise and for what I think would be the best thing moving forward is cutting the model's face so that we don't have to rely on a full AI face for all the photography on your website, but you're still showcasing a real person. I guess I say real, but it's really an AI generated person. So the idea is that we're doing a close up and we're just focusing on the design of the shirt. And that's what this prompt is all about. If you want this prompt, we'll have it in the description below. You can grab it yourself. And then after this simple prompt, we just have a few style notes and focus notes right here towards the end. And really all we've done is just make sure that it's a 3/4 on the aspect ratio. And then for the type of, because the thing about Higgs Field is that they are, at the end of the day, that they try to add a little bit more style and artisticness, right, to their photography and the videos. So you do have to pick a sort of like a style guide, or a visual style is what they call it. But for this example, we just click general, and general just kind of gets you that, it's general, but you do have to pick something. So once you do that, just click generate. And from this prompt, we get this right here, exactly what we wanted. We wanted a woman wearing a soft pastel pink shirt, again, with the focus on that chest area so we can get a design right within there. Now, next up, we're gonna add the actual design and the graphic element of my brand into this one right here. But before we do that, I just wanna say, hey, my name is Christian Pignon. I'm one of the co-founders here at Big Branding. We specialize in helping clothing brands scale online. We've served over 300 clothing brands in the last year alone. I would appreciate it if you like and subscribe so that you don't miss any of our latest content. Once we have these, obviously it's gonna give you 4 different options. From these options, you just wanna click the one that you like the most, right? And when you actually click on it, it's gonna give you if you need to, right, tweak it a little bit, you can also, you know, tweak that particular image and even go a little bit further, a little bit deeper into it. But for this example, we wanna get our first just model ready to go with our design on it. So what we're gonna click on here is edit in Canvas. Now, Canvas is sort of like another tool. As you can see at the very top, we switch from create to Canvas. Think of Canvas as like, you already created something, you already have something, and you want to edit that something. So all we're doing here really is we're selecting the area. So we're using the paint tool to select the area where we want the actual design. I did a horrible job there. And right here on the bottom left-hand side, instead of sold in paint, we want to do product placement. So we're placing a product, but we're just placing the design right within here. So we're going to grab an object, and this example, all I have is this orange guy. So we're going to use this orange guy, and then we're going to click generate. I don't even have a prompt or anything for this. You just really want to paint the area. Grab your actual design graphic, and you hit generate. I will say, from my experience and some of the tests that we've done, smaller text details tend not to translate very well. But if you have a kind of more of a general design, that usually one for one, it will be almost immediate. So let's click generate. Okay, so these are some of the options that we got. We got that one. So you see, like, this one completely just changed. That one's the same. Okay, so for whatever reason, two of them absolutely changed the design of, I guess not even, the design is the same. It's just the pose that the little orange man is doing. This one's one for one. Yeah, that's exactly what we needed there for our product. And that, I mean, there you have it. Like, that's a studio quality AI model that doesn't look too AI-ish, but it allows us to create our designs into Higgsfield, right? Now, let's go over some few hacks in here. Higgsfield does cost money. So in order to generate, even to create, right, that first initial model photo within that prompt, you can actually use that prompt and you can go into image effects and you can copy and paste that prompt right within here. Let me see if I can go grab that real quick. This one will be slightly different. We can grab that prompt, put it in here. And the one thing that I will say that you will probably have to change will be the aspect ratio for it. So the 3:4, click generate. And this will give you some free AI generated photos. So then you can just put it into Higgsfield and put in your designs on your product photos. So as you can see, now we have the models in here. We still have that kind of consistency of white background, cutting off the head of the model, but still being able to showcase the chest area for the design. Now, let's say you don't want to do this particular prompt that we have right here. You want to do something maybe slightly different. Like, go to your competition. I'm on Skims right here. Oh, this is Post Malone, nice. Go to your competition, look up their photography, what they're doing. Like, okay, trade male, African-American, looking straight into the camera, not smiling, just kind of standing there shoulder width apart. Like, that image, you can actually grab it, we can copy it, we can put it on ChatGPT, and we can ask ChatGPT to describe this image. So then you're not necessarily copying it one for one, but you're getting the style element of it. So you grab the image, you put it on ChatGPT, you ask it to just describe this image so I can prompt it to another AI, you know, generator out there. Then you go to image effects, you put in that prompt in here, and now you have almost like an unlimited glitch on getting model photography templates for your products. Now, the beauty about Higgsfield is that we're just literally touching the surface on the things that it can do. On the next video, and if you're interested, please let me know in the comments below. I want to create some cool video content that we can actually use for ads. And how does that actually look like, right? After you create the videos here for Higgsfield, how does that look like after the fact? So you can actually put together some kind of interesting video ad for your potential customers. So let me know in the comments below, and we'll see you on the next one.